Hello learners, welcome to NIOS Studio. This program is based on Senior Secondary Chemistry course. We'll be discussing about Lesson 6, The Solid State. I'm Dr. Alka Mehrotra. In the previous video, we have discussed about the closed pack structure in 1, 2 and 3 dimensions and different types of voids. Now we'll be discussing about the packing efficiency and classification of solids based on electrical conductivity. So the objective is packing efficiency, classification of solids based on their electrical conductivities and their magnetic properties. Now packing efficiency, what exactly is packing efficiency? As we know, solids are very closely packed. So how much efficient is a solid is defined by the packing efficiency. So packing efficiency, what is packing efficiency? The solids are how closely packed in the crystal lattice is a packing efficiency, because it should be very efficient in packing. There should not be any void. I'm going to discuss this on the board with you. So let's discuss about packing efficiency for simple cubic unit cell. Here, you can see here the cube is there, and the atoms, as I told you, is present on the corner, that is a lattice point is there, and here you have all the atoms present. And in simple cubic cell, we have already discussed only at the corners there are each atom is present over there. So there's a formula of packing efficiency. This is the volume of one atom divided by volume of cubic unit cell multiplied by 100%. Now volume of cube, as if we take this side as A, so the volume of cube is A cube. Now you can see over here the two atoms are there, and this A is covered by radii of the two atoms. It means if this is our radius, it means A is equal to 2R. Now here, we can say A is equal to 2R, hence A cube is equal to 2R cube, that is 8R cube. Now let's put this in our formula. Packing efficiency is the volume of one atom. You know the volume of one atom or sphere is 4 by 3 pi R cube. Now divided by volume of cubic cell. Now cubic cell we have already taken out 8R cube. Now let's put this in the formula. And keeping the value of pi is 3.14, put this in that and we will get 52.36 or 52.4%. So this 52.4% is a packing efficiency of simple cubic cell. It means the remaining parts are the voids. Now let's discuss packing efficiency of body-centered cubic cells. Now body-centered, as we have discussed in the previous video, what is body-centered? Where on each lattice point there will be a cube. So there will be spheres will be there. So that means one is definitely there. Body means in whole body you can see one sphere is there. So one is here. Now how to find out this little bit? Geometrical skills you have to apply over here. So in, let's take the triangle EFD. In EFD, if you see, this is here, as we know that all are 90 degrees. So if you see, this is also 90 degrees. So hypotenuse is this. So if we put Pythagoras theorem, we have hypotenuse square, that is B square, is equal to a square plus a square, that is 2a square. So what will be the value of b? B is root 2a. Now let's check AFD. AFD. Now again, here we can see this is again the 90 degree is there. So opposite to that will be your 90 degree angle. So if we take AFD, so this will be C square equals to A square plus B square if we take it as a B. Okay, so now C square is equal to A square plus B square, but we have already discussed that B square is equal to 2A square. Now, keeping this b square value over here, we have a square plus 2a square, which makes 3a square. Now, let's take again the cube root of the c value will be root 3a. Now, length of the body diagonal, that is c, that is 4 into r. How 4 into r? Because this 1r, this much, as you know, we have from here to here, the value is c. This is 1r, 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 and 1r. That means 4r. So c is equal to 4r. 4r is equal to root 3a. Now, how come? Because we have already found out that c is equal to root 3a. So now, keeping this value root 3 over here, we get this. Now, let's find out the value of r. R is root 3 upon 4 into a. Or we can say a value, because we have to find out the volume, a is equal to 4r upon root 3. Again, let's put the value in the formula. Formula, as we have already discussed, the packing efficiency is volume of the filled space. Now, the filled space is what? This we have already found out. 4 by 3 pi r cube, but how many atoms are there? 2 atoms. We have discussed that in body centered, 1 is in the total and 1 is more. So, 2 into 4 by 3 pi r cube. And what is the area of the total square? That is a cube. But let's put the value of a over here. We get 4r upon root 3 cube. Now, if you solve this equation, we will get 68%. Now, here you can check. This was 52.4. This is 68%. It means this one here, the packing is more. So, it means this solid will be more efficient in packing. This is a face-centered cubic. As you know, in face-centered, there are 6 faces, means 3 atoms and one more of this simple cubic cell. So, there are total 4 atoms over there. Now, let's check. Let's take the triangle ABC. In this, the diagonal is, this is B, because again, all are 90 degree, it means this is the hypotenuse. So, by applying the Pythagoras theorem, we have B square is equal to A square plus A square. So, we get B is equal to root 2A. Now, B is equal to 4A. How? Because if you check this line, how the atoms are arranged, atom is 1 here, it means half of the radius. This one here, this is full, it means a diameter, which means 2r, and again 1r, that makes 4r. So, b is equal to 4r. So, now let's put the value of b over here. So, 4r is equal to root 2a. Now, we are substituting the value of b over here. So, a will be 4r divided by root 2, or we can say a is equal to 2 root 2 r we'll get. Now, each unit cell in cubic this one is 4 spheres. Rather, we can say this 4 atoms are there in that. Each unit cell in CCP has 1, but total all in FCP you can say over there, that is 4 spheres. Now, packing efficiency, again the same formula, volume of filled space upon total space. So, the filled space, as we know, there are 4 spheres. One sphere volume is 4 by 3 pi r cube multiplied by 4 divided by again the total space, that is the total volume of the cube. Now, the total volume we have already discussed and we have taken out 2 root 2. Now, keeping the value of A over there, we get 2 root 2 r cube. So, calculating, you get 74%. So, what are we going to conclude over there? In this, we can conclude that the packing efficiency is best in face-centered unit cell. And we have already discussed before, like many atoms are present over there. So, that's the 74%. Then packing efficiency for the body-centered cubic unit cell, 68%. And then packing efficiency for the simple cubic cell is 52.4%, because there is no other atom present apart from the lattice point. the atoms in the solid are properly arranged, it doesn't mean that they do not have any defect. There are defects. Now, crystal, we can say that there are two kind of defects over there. One is point defect, other is line defect. Point defects are the irregularities or deviation from ideal arrangement around a point or an atom in the crystalline substance. So, only at one point you will find this deficiency. Line defects, as the name is suggesting, line defects are the irregularities or deviation from ideal arrangement in entire rows of the lattice point. So, this is the flow chart. You can see over there defects. Now, let's discuss this one by one. Different type of point defects. This is the impurity defect. Here you can see it's a crystal of sodium chloride, but there is an impurity of strontium chloride. Now you can see here the strontium is also there and the impurity over there. So this is the impurity, but the point defect. At only one point the atom is not here. Now different type of stoichiometric defects are the non-ionic. When some lattice sites are vacant. So, we say that it's a vacancy defect. Suppose the atoms are arranged but few atoms are missing. So, that is the vacancy defect and it decreases the density of the solid because the atoms are missing. Then interstitial defect. A crystal is said to have interstitial defect when some constituent particles, either atom or molecule, occupy an interstitial site. So, this defect results in increase in density of the substance because it is taking an interstitial site. Now, then we have a Frenkel or a dislocation defect. In this defect, the smaller ion, usually you know in cation anion, cations are the smaller one. Now you can locate from there, it is dislocated from its normal site to an interstitial site. It creates a vacancy defect in its original site and an interstitial defect at the new location. It does not change the density of the solid. Frenkel defect is shown by ionic substance in which there is a large difference in the size of ion, you know, cations are usually smaller and anions are little bigger in size. So, that is the one will be missing over there, or we can say the dislocate, not missing, dislocation will be there. Now, Schottky effect. In Schottky in ionic crystal, this type of point defect forms when oppositely charged ion leave their lattice site creating vacancy. Now, you can see here the blue ones and the orange one, the cations and anions, one oppositely charged, that is cation, and one anion, sodium and chloride ions are missing over there. So, that is they leave their lattice rather. So, that is the Schottky defect. Now, let's classify the solids on their electrical conductivity. Now, as we know, the solids are good conductors. Now, the solids which conduct the conductivity ranging between 10 to the power 4 to 10 to the power 7 ohm minus 1 meter minus 1 are the good conductors. Insulator, those are the solids which have very low conductivity, that is ranging from 10 power minus 20 to 10 power minus 10 per ohm meter. Conduction of electricity in metals. The conductivity of metals depend on the number of valence electrons available per atom. Partial filling or overlapping with a higher energy unoccupied conduction band enables the electrons to flow easily under applied electrical field. This results in conductivity of metals. If the gap between valence band and the conduction band is large, electrons cannot jump to it. And such a substance has a low conductivity that makes it behave like an insulator. Conduction of electricity in semiconductors, the gap between the valence band and conduction band is small. This enables some electrons to jump to conduction band and exhibit their conductivity. Electrical conductivity of semiconductors increases with increase in temperature. Since more electrons can jump to the conduction band due to small gap between the valence band and conduction band. Examples of semiconductors are silicon and germanium. This is how it happens. This is what I explained to you. You can have a look over there. The gap, please check the gap. Now, doping. The conductivity of metal is increased by adding an appropriate amount of suitable impurity. This process is known as doping. It can be performed with an impurity which is electron rich or electron deficient than the intrinsic semiconductor, silicon or germanium. If sodium chloride is doped with 10⁻³ mole percent of strontium chloride, what is the concentration of the cation we can see? So, one cation of strontium is equal to one cation we can see in sodium chloride. Classification of substances based on their magnetic property. Paramagnetic substances. These are those substances which are weakly attracted by magnetic field. It is due to the presence of one or more unpaired electrons. Diamagnetic. Diamagnetic substances are weakly repelled by magnetic field. Diamagnetism is shown by those substances in which all the electrons are paired and there are no unpaired electrons. Ferromagnetic. These are those substances which are attracted strongly by the magnetic field. Antiferromagnetic substances. They have equal number of parallel and anti-parallel magnetic dipoles resulting in a zero net dipole moment. Ferrimagnetic substances, they have unequal number of parallel and anti-parallel magnetic dipoles resulting in a dipole moment. So, here we have discussed in this video the packing efficiency, classification of solid based on their electrical conductivity, classification of substances based on their magnetic properties. Thank you.